Hey, hi. Assalamualaikum and salam sejahtera semua. So, today cikgu nak ajar alright about introduction to the carbon compound. So, I think this is something new to you. Tapi once we go through the pages of this textbook, cikgu dapati benda ni dah belajar dah dekat form 3 sikit-sikit. Alright, so now we go to the carbon compound. So the first part is the carbon compound in nature. So now, carbon compound are compound which contain the element carbon. Okay, compound that contain the element carbon. Dia kata ada element carbon. Alright, so any compound that contain element carbon, maksudnya kita namakan dia as a carbon compound. So now, carbon compound can be divided into two groups, namely organic carbon compounds and inorganic carbon compound. Okay, so now jom kita tengok what is organic and inorganic carbon compound. So we know that carbon compound can be divided into two, organic carbon compound and inorganic carbon compound. So rupanya how to differentiate these two adalah dia punya source, daripada originate dia daripada mana. So, if it is organic carbon compound, it comes from the living things. Kalau inorganic carbon compounds, they come from the non-living things. So, perbezaan dia hanyalah perkataan in. Boleh? So, contoh untuk organic carbon compound. Alright, contoh that source come from the living things, dia adalah petroleum, silt dan juga charcoal. Kita tahu kalau petroleum ni daripada fosil kan, yang dah lama mendap. Dekat form 3, you all dah belajar lah benda ni. Okay, yang dah lama mendap. So, lama-lama selepas bertahun-tahun lamanya, berjuta-juta tahun, dapat petroleum. Silt daripada ulat sutera. Okay, kemudian charcoal daripada pokok lah, kayu balak kan. Now, daripada kayu-kayu. So, now, kalau daripada non-living things, limestone, batu kapur. Okay, kemudian carbon dioxide kita dapat daripada persekitaran kita. So, this is two types of carbon compound, organic and inorganic. So, now kita pergi kepada carbon cycle. Carbon cycle ni pun dah belajar dah dekat form 1. Entahlah awak ingat ke tak ingat, dekat form 1 you already learn about carbon cycle. So, now carbon cycle shows how carbon element are recycled. Macam mana dia recycle? Through the formation or decomposition of carbon compound in living things and organic substances in the environment through the processes such as respiration, combustion, decomposition and photosynthesis. So, from the diagram pun you dah tengok kan. So, this is a carbon cycle. Alright, kalau kita tengok dekat sini, ada banyak factors that produce carbon dioxide. Tapi hanya satu proses sahaja yang absorb carbon dioxide from the surrounding. Betul tak? So, kalau you tengok sini, pokok. Pokok pun melakukan respiration. Animal pun melakukan respiration. So, this process definitely akan supply carbon dioxide to our atmosphere. Kemudian, jika our green plant, alright, and our animal mati, which is dead organism, alright, dia akan melalui proses decay process. So, this process also release carbon dioxide to the surrounding. So now we know that our vehicle, factories, our house, we are cooking dekat rumah ke apa ke kan. Penggunaan fossil fuel, alright, petroleum, natural gas and coal. We burning of this fuel akan produce juga carbon dioxide. Kemudian, this carbon dioxide definitely, alright, akan apa? Akan absorb by photosynthesis. By plant lah, akan absorb by plant through the process of the photosynthesis. So kita akan tengok lah this carbon cycle akan recycle. Kenapa kena recycle? To maintain the level of the carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. Kenapa pentingnya carbon cycle? Cik tulis sini. To maintain the level of carbon. Cikgu buat short form lah nak. Carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. Next, kita pergi kepada next page. Carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere through three main processes. Yang pertama is respiration. Cikgu tak perlu cerita dengan lebih lanjut lah. Ia involve all living things. All living things mesti respirate. Respiration ni apa dia? They use oxygen and then produce carbon dioxide. So all living things ni termasuklah animal, plant and microorganisms. So now, combustion. Combustion, alright, dia adalah burning of fossil fuels release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. Kita mesti burn. Nama apa combustion kan? Combustion juga is one of the process that use oxygen and produce carbon dioxide. So, natural phenomena such as volcanic eruption and forest fire also will release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. So, this process akan increase, this to the process, akan increase the carbon dioxide content in the atmosphere. So, now we go to the next thing, which is decomposition. Decomposition is a process di mana decomposers such as bacteria and fungi, alright, bacteria and fungi, process of decomposition by decomposers. Contohnya jika ada haiwan-haiwan yang mati kan, dead animal apa semua, so decomposers ni yang akan try to decompose all this dying animal and plant itu untuk jadi simple things untuk diserap balik dalam tanah. So that process akan also release carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. As we all know that carbon dioxide can be absorbed by only green plant. Alright, from the atmosphere. Alright, green plant akan absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere to carry out photosynthesis. So, jadi apa importance of photosynthesis? What is the importance of photosynthesis dekat sini? So, kita ada 4 point here according to your textbook. The first one is to enabling green plant to make their own food. Okay. Kemudian, providing food to animals, increasing the oxygen content in the air, and removing excess carbon dioxide from the air to maintain carbon dioxide content in the air. Ini sama dengan apa yang cikgu cakap dekat depan tadi lah. Okay, dekat depan tadi ni kan, cikgu dah cakap to maintain the level of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. So, itu sahaja untuk hari ini. Cikgu akan continue dengan next lesson video. Bye. Assalamualaikum.